do that. Righty. Everyone has been admitted. Okay, so I'll go ahead and start with a few comments. Thank you very much, everyone, for attending. I might say that so far, this is the biggest attendance for our department, so that's wonderful. Glad to see you all here. I'll leave my camera on for now. I might turn it off in a minute because I am going to share my screen. But the topic of this session is Let Me See Your ID. It's a marketing and branding session. I'm going to give you some strategies that you can use for your school and parish online and print, and also especially in social media. I'm going to switch our topics around. I know the paper's sign up you received said we were going to talk about, Facebook, social media type things first. But I'm going to go ahead and talk about branding and marketing first. But before I do, I'll introduce myself to those of you that I don't know. Can you see it? You might want to, I think either Jen or Julie back in here.
Okay, I'm not in there.
Okay, hold on one second. Let the school's office get situated. Girl's good. Let's see. That'll help. Okay, that should be good. Okay, let's try this. Okay, again, I'm Joyce Bybee. I am your manager in the marketing office for writing and social media. And I'll just give you a little bit about me. I grew up in Glendale, West Virginia, which isn't far from Wheeling. And I went to St. Francis grade school, Bishop John New High School. So I'm a big time supporter of Catholic schools because I am a product of Catholic schools. I went on to Fairmont State and got a degree in journalism and graphic arts. And then I went to Columbus, Ohio and for 12 years. So I have a newspaper background and also editing background. I worked for the Times Leader here in the Ohio Valley. Then I also worked for the Columbus Dispatch in Columbus, Ohio, before I came back here to raise my kids with my husband. Our kids, Boyd and Lane, are also products of Catholic school, and both are in college or graduate school right now. Let's see, what else did I tell you? Oh, when I came back to West Virginia, I served as a secretary and office manager for St. Jude in Glendale before I became the advancement director for Our Lady of Peace School. And that's also in Wheeling, but it's in the Marshall County section of Wheeling. And I know we have Amy Thalman here today with us, and she is in that current role there. So as you can see, I have worn the hats in both the parish arena and the school arena, so I can sympathize on all of the demands that you all have for your jobs. Currently, as I said, as manager of writing and social media, I do a ton of stuff for the diocese. It's so much fun, and I hope it helps you all. We put together the Faith in West Virginia e-bulletin, also Faith in West Virginia feature stories. That will deal a lot with my session I'm doing tomorrow, if you want to join in with that. And then I do all the social media for the diocese, the Facebook account, the Twitter account, the Instagram account, and then other entities that we have under the Chancery umbrella. I help those folks with their accounts when they need it. And then things that I write also show up in the Catholic Spirit, so you might know my name from that. So right now, I am going to go ahead and share my screen, which, let's see here, if I can do this, I might need help. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Can you all see this screen where it says, let me see your ID? Anyone? Let's see.
Yeah, Joyce, that's good.
Okay, good. All right. I'm going to go to a present mode so that you don't have to look at my screen, and it's all of my templates I use. All righty. How's that? Everyone good? right, I'm going to keep going. All right, so let's get started. So we all need our IDs for everything. Let me move this little guy over here as far as I can. And what's important on it? What's important on it is your photo, your image, the date, and all the information that, you know, Lord help us, we don't get pulled over and have to give all that out. But anyway, same goes for your parish and your school. You want to keep those, that all of that information current. You want your photo and images that are on your website, on your newsletters, on your Facebook page, on your webpage. They all need to be relatively current. And if they're not current, they need to be something historical that's very important to your parish or school or organization. The dates on your pages need to be reflective of the most current dates. I'm going to get into that later as well. And keep your information up to date. Make sure the principal is who the principal is currently. That sounds simple, but sometimes we forget those things in the midst of all of the rushing around that we do. If you have a new parish secretary, make sure her picture is up there, and so on and so forth. So let's just keep that in mind so that we can stay out of PR jail, I call it. Think of everything, your website, your bulletin, your newsletter, your social media, and ask yourself over and over, are these current? And does your ID truly represent yourself? And what do I mean by that? Well, there's a few things to consider. How do you look? So in the diocese, if you look at our logo, or our shield, I should say, down here in the right corner is our shield for the diocese. So if I want to stay within those color ranges, you'll see we'll often use red, green, black, gold, and often gray. So I'm going to use those colors throughout my presentation. See if you can pick up on those as we go. But think about how you look. A new St. Paul's school, which I have down here at the bottom, they've recently done a lot on their website with the two gentlemen here, Rob and Nick, who have helped Kim a ton. And their website looks so welcoming, not confusing, but she has so much information here. If you look, less is more. She has one great picture, and I do believe her pictures scroll. You can scroll through them. Same with St. James the Greater, one great picture. Obviously, it's their parish. Simple little directory lines here for the school. Schedule a tour, apply now. Quick, easy access to the phone number. They are not making you scroll to the bottom of the page at St. Paul's to get that, or the email address. That's huge, because how many times do you go to a website or any site and try to, you know, contact them, you're scrolling all the way to the bottom. St. Mary's School, look how clean. They're welcoming the picture, their front door there, and all of these cool little buttons down here where you can get your information. It's a very trendy thing to do with a little icon. All of those things are current and up to date. I want you to pay special attention right here to this. This is the dates I was talking about. St. James the Greater has this wonderful mass schedule. So basically, whether you're a parish or a school, this would be your calendar information. So theirs is very current on what there is. Notice this is kind of a stagnant situation where they don't have a lot of change in the schedule, but they could easily slip a change in. So when you do have a calendar on your page, just make sure that it is current. If it's something you don't want to have to change a lot, maybe do what St. James the Greater does and make a stagnant one right here. But remember, less is more. Look at all this information you get right here on these three sites just by looking at that first page that would come up on your regular screen. But it doesn't look too overwhelming. It's all, you know, concise right there at your fingertips. Compliment yourself. Look at these websites, St. James the Greater, they redo these colors. You have this maroonish purple color complemented down here in these text fonts. You have the blue bars complementing each other. Same with St. Mary's in Clarksburg. Same with the blue. That's one of their school colors. It's down here in their icons. St. Paul's too. Excellent job there. Clean out your closet. If it's something on your front page that you don't like, get rid of it. If you need help, give Rob or Nick a call and see if they can help you get rid of it. If you're kind of in a snafu, I'm not sure on how to get rid of something on your page. And think of it sometimes too, as an outsider, go to your page as someone else. And what information do you want to find? You want to find that phone number. There it is, St. Paul's. Great job again. You want to find how to contact them. You want to schedule a tour, maybe just get some general information about admissions. If you're a parish, you want mass times. That's quick and easy. Right there it is, St. James Greater. Boom, top of the page, all the mass times. Those are common things that people want quickly. And those are a great job right there on getting that information to the visitor. So how do you compliment yourself? As I mentioned, and he hinted the last slide, a lot of the compliments are colors. What are your colors of your parish predominantly? I grew up at St. Jude, I said, and in St. Jude, for whatever reason, we use a lot of green down at St. Jude. So you'll see if you hit their website, I just helped design that, oh my gosh, 15 years ago or more, a lot of it will be green. Here, I pulled, and Kim, you are really great with a lot of this stuff already, but I want you guys to write this down, because a lot of times we forget these things, but compliment each other going from platform to platform. So let your newsletters, your bulletins, your website, your social media, let it all compliment each other. Keep pulling those colors, keep repeating. I know Kim does a great job with the green, Our Lady of Peace with blue, even the schools you'll see with the mountains, they're really selective in the colors they choose to represent the diocesan school, to represent all of you. So let those colors be consistent. Also fonts, let those be consistent, the style and how you present them. Taglines, I know Our Lady of Peace is using the theme this year, Build Peace. Many of our schools pick a theme each year. Stick that as your tagline and put that everywhere you can. Put it on your social media posts, put it in your newsletter, put it in on your Facebook, all your social media, even every post, just do a hashtag build peace, hashtag whatever your theme might be for the year. If you're a parish and you don't do a yearly theme, maybe do a campaign you're doing to raise money for this, that, or the other. Or if there is also a certain slogan that you use at your parish. You know, it could be something as simple as St. Michael, pray for us on everything you do. Always use your logo. I've been trying to, and I'm not perfect at this, but when I do create a social media post, and it's something I've created in Canva, that's a platform I use a lot, and I'd be happy to share with you anytime more information on how to do that. But when I do create my own graphic, I put the logo in the, usually the bottom right or somewhere on the graphic. So if you're creating a graphic, make sure you place that logo on the graphic. And as I said, we don't have to recreate the wheel in order to be good. Kim, as soon as I mentioned this slide, I said I wanted you to write something down, and that's this: don't recreate the wheel. This information I have here, these three images, they're from a school in Dayton. When I was in Columbus, I belonged to the National Schools of Public Relations Association. They have a great contest every year to award their top PR people in whether it's a print, a digital platform that they've done, that you've submit entries, and the best practices are highlighted and receive national awards. This was one from Dayton. And you will see, I put this here because it talks about everything I told you, using that tagline, putting it as a hashtag, using the colors. Look at these logos. They've used their school logo here, but they had a tagline, be present for a better future. This is different ways they presented it, all looking very much similar. And here it is in a flyer they created. Here are some graphics they used on social media, and it's repeated, repeated, repeated. Don't be afraid to repeat. And don't think that you have to recreate the wheel. We're all here for you at the Chancery office in the marketing department. And then our gentlemen, Rob and Nick, with the website, totally here to help you. If something comes up within the schools, give the school office a call and they'll get me in touch with you and get in touch with me directly. If it's something with parish, please feel free to contact me directly as well. It's great to be copycats of good habits, design, and communication. And I'm actually learning from all of you too, because when I get the chance, I love looking at your social media. I love looking at your website, seeing what's going on in the schools. And, you know, all of that is flattery when we imitate each other. And with that, I want to say that, and let's continue to do that. Let's continue to be copycats. We create, as I said, the Faith in West Virginia e-bulletin, in that each week we write about some significant saints that might be coming up, some significant holy days. We have prayer intentions in there. If you need any of those items, go grab the Faith in West Virginia e-bulletin, which should be sent to your email directly. If it's not, let me know. But it's also available at the dwc.org. website. If you scroll to the bottom of the page, you can go to Faith in West Virginia e-bulletin for archived editions or current ones, and steal those articles about the saints, those photos, use those, or just go to our social media at the diocese, either Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, and share our things. Even if you don't have time to write a post yourself, you can share those things, and it's keeping your social media in the eyes and on those news lines and timelines of your parents and your parishioners. So keep doing that, and also check other schools. I know I mentioned Kim and Amy on here because I know them, but keep, you know, follow each other. Follow your you know, each other's social media pages, and copy what you like from each other. Contact each other. Let's all play well in the sandbox together. So yes, share and share alike. You don't see my top screen here with my icons of where I go to every day, but every morning when I turn on the internet here, I always click on, obviously I bring up to on my page, check out the Diocese of Wheeling-Charleston.org, the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops.org, the VaticanNews.va, which is the Vatican. And then I call up all my social media pages. So if you were sitting at my computer, all of these tabs would be open at any given time. And why do I do that? I go to just because I know how important it is to be on social media and to share every current information. I'll go to usccb.org, see if in the latest news items, there's anything that I need to share on our social media. And I'll either share it directly from there, or I'll create my own post that personalizes it to the diocese. Something I think you would want to know in our parishes or our schools. Same holds true with the Vatican News. I do the same there. I might go through the news tab, the Pope's section, the Vatican in general, the church, and then there's a world tab. And under the world tab is all the different continents, and it might show information for the United States, Africa, so on and so forth. So with all of this, and as I've told you to have eyes and ears open for your diocese, the USCCB, the Vatican, and each other. Also, very important for your pages and your social media is to identify the social media influences in your community, in your organization. So your school parents or your parish families. We all know someone who seems to have they're always on social media, they're always on Facebook or Twitter, or they're doing Instagram. identify those people, approach them personally and say, hey, will you be cognizant and share my posts that we place on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter? And when you do, then people who they follow and who follow them rather will get to see your information over and over more than just when you put it up yourself. So it's so important to share your social media that way, by directly in person going up to the person or calling them and saying, hey, could you please share our school social media posts, or please share our parish social media posts. And likewise, I consider you all social media influences. So as I said, I look to you and try to share what you can. If I don't see your social media posts, just because I have, I don't know, 120, forget how many that I try to follow of all of us, contact me by email or send me a message somehow. So I am aware that you want me to share your social media post, a specific one about an event or a person or a program. That would be beneficial for everyone in the diocese to see, and beneficial for you as well. That's all about sharing and sharing alike and playing well in that sandbox together. So we're moving on to our social media taming the jungle. My husband jokingly calls Facebook Jungle Book. So it just sticks in my head. It truly is. He's right. Social media is a jungle. I look at Facebook as a great, bulletin board of information and a great way to stay in touch with friends, family, school, alumni. And it's also Twitter, when I look at it and I think, oh my gosh, there's so many opinions there. Instagram, so many awesome pictures and so many wonderful things to either celebrate, pray about. It's all in how you look at your social media and how you present it. And that again is about your ID. So think about how you want to be perceived. And I think unanimously that would be, we all want to be a positive, strong Catholic identity, unapologetically Catholic identity on social media, to evangelize as Bishop Mark wants us to do, and to evangelize as the Pope wants us to do, and to be cognizant of all the people around us. So we can do that. And with that said, social media, timing is everything. Be cognizant of what's going on in your school or your parish daily. I know it's harder in parishes because we don't do a lot of things daily, but we do things and we plan ahead. Keep putting those up on social media. Even if you're having, Our Lady of Peace has this really cool bonfire every year. They just had it this past weekend. When you have events like that, make sure you don't just put it up once and check it off your list that it's up. 2 and 3 weeks out, keep telling people, reminding people that it's happening. It's that, you know, it's quickly approaching. Or in the incidence of Our Lady of Peace, had to be canceled a couple of times due to weather. But keep putting those posts out. As you know, social media can be overwhelming, but sometimes it can be pleasantly overwhelming. Keep reminding people, get those messages out, as y'all know, or should know, in public relations. You have to tell somebody 7 times is the little statistic that you have to tell someone 7 times over before it sinks in their head all of the details of the event or the information that you want to tell them. So timing is everything. If you have an event going on a certain day, post the pictures and information of that event that day. I know it's asking a lot, but don't wait till the next day to post them unless you are posting an album. If you're going to make a post on social media, it needs to be current. It needs to be timely. It needs to be now, not yesterday, not last week. You just need to be disciplined and have that good habit of getting it up and posted the day it happens. And I know that moms especially love this when things are going on in the school day, they're not there. And especially during COVID, when you as a school advancement directors or principals would post things on your social media during the school day. And we would hear, you know, I know the school's office has, when they visited the schools, what a wonderful blessing that's been for them to keep in touch and to feel a part of what's going on in the school. So timing is everything. Please do everything current. If you do have to post an event that happened the day before, I would just suggest I'm putting it in an album. It kind of acknowledges that, hey, this was, you know, worth repeating. This happened yesterday, and then make that into an album and post a bunch of pictures up there. And also tomorrow in my PACE session with Faith in West Virginia, I will include some tidbits on how to write a press release and how to take good pictures. I think all of you probably do that pretty well. Real quick, I'll give you a 5-second synopsis. Don't put any more than 7 people in a picture if you don't have to. Sometimes you do, sometimes you want a group picture for the effect. But if you're trying to identify a bunch of people so they don't get too lost, try to do 7 or less. Obviously, again, and I know it's impossible all the time to do that when you have a group, a club, et cetera, et cetera. But if it's a feature picture, don't take a wide view of the kickball game, because that doesn't show anything. Just take a picture of the kickball player, or when you have a fish fry, don't feel like you need to take a picture of everyone in the kitchen at once. Take a picture of the person handing out the fish or at the fryer. Think of those small moments, make it personal instead of impersonal. So insights are big. We'll go over that in a minute, and then follow the leader. Let's all play well and share alike. Follow those leaders, and I'll tell you more how you can identify those even outside our community, outside our diocese. So let's move on. And here is insights. So for those of you who have Facebook pages, you're well aware of these. This is pretty awesome. If you look down here on this first slide, if I go to my diocesan Facebook page, there is an insights little icon here. It's like a blood pressure line almost. That's what you want to click, and it'll bring you over to a plethora of information for you that gives you all kinds of detail about, who's reading your posts, what time they're online, what days they're online. This is my most important part. We have our readership for the diocese Facebook page pretty much standard every day, you know, about 4,500 people, 4,600 people look at it at any given time. You'll see my posts for the diocese scheduled for 5 something a.m. usually, because that's my peak of between 5 and 6 a.m. Then it goes up again around 8 to 9, 9:30. Then I go again and do some more posts more around 2, 2:30, 3 o'clock, because I have more readership then. Then my readers really peak around 5:30 to 6:30 hour before they drop down. So that's when I know I'll have readers online who, if my posts show up on their newsline or their timeline, then I'm more apt to get more readers for my posts. So those insights are important to know. If you don't understand how to get there, what that means, or if you don't have a Facebook page set up, please contact me and I will be more than happy to either FaceTime you or come visit you and get you situated on that. This is more of my Facebook insights on what I look at, because there's so many cool tips here that you don't have to do too much homework for in the Facebook insights. This over here is my 5 most recent posts as of the day I click this to show you. In here, I can see the dates that I posted, the times that I posted. There's those hours I try to talk to you about. Sometimes, even though it's not a peak time, I try to get the lunch hour in, works usually to get people engaged. A really cool feature I like is pages to watch. I know that Our Lady Peace has this set up on theirs, and Kim, I'm certain you probably do too. Years ago, when we had a lot more face-to-face workshops here at the diocese for advancement directors and parish office managers, we would have a group come in to help us with this area. And these are mine. I choose are the Archdiocese of Chicago Archdiocese of Baltimore, the Diocese of Nashville, and I like to compare what we're doing to them. Why? Because I really like these programs, their schools, their way they communicate. It's kind of like a best practices for me. So I like to measure what I'm doing to them. So it's that outside the box, share and share alike kind of thing. You might see something we do and then hop over to Nashville and you might see Nashville doing the same thing or vice versa. We've had, I've been contacted by folks in Germany, folks in Miami, different ones who have liked our social media posts and were able to share those, and we've exchanged information back and forth. So it's pretty cool to add those folks to your watch. But these are the ones, these are my top three that I kind of watch to set my pace. So moving right along, this is some information for you that I thought was important. And I know this information, it's basically news, like how you get your news in general. But I want you to take a note of the importance of digital and print, and in this case, digital over print. Both for us, because we are parishes and schools, are vitally important. I do not want you to discontinue one or the other, but I just did want to show you that. In general, Americans do use their smartphone, computer, and tablet to get their news. That's 86% of people have a smartphone, computer, tablet as a vehicle to get their news. There are 68% still getting it on the television. And that's, you know, obviously we get our news in multiple fashions. So this isn't just, you can see the math here. It's not just out of 100%. This is just how they're using it. But print publications, look at that. It's only 32%. People typically at 32% of their time only go to print publications 32% of the time. So what does that say? Yeah, your newsletters in print are still important. Bulletins are vitally important, I think, because people like those paper documents, but you gotta make those available online. You have to, get information out for people to quickly find it. And I have become part of the generation that can't find things right now. Once I went over that 50-year-old hump anyway, but you do have to present your information digitally in print. And the more you offer your bulletin and newsletter digitally, the more apt you're gonna have folks to read it. Oops, let me get this off of there. So keeping right along with our schedule, know your audience. Repeat your message, like I just said, both digital and print. Don't just put it one place and check it off the list and now you're done. Put it everywhere. So if you have social media, it needs to go in there. Put it on your website, put it on your e-bulletin, put it in your bulletin, your print newsletter, all of those. Here is just a little graphic I found from also Pew Research. Those under 50, obviously, that's no brainer. Get their information from digital devices. But look at this. I find this interesting. Even those 65 and older are using their smartphone or computer or tablet. 48% are doing that for their news. So it, again, it shows you the importance of your digital and print platforms in every regard. So here's for parishes, a lot of our parish population is 50 and over. So here again, digital and print are very important. For your school parents, right here we are in this 29 for preschool parents probably category to the 49-year-old category, huge digital users, small print users. So if you're thinking about e-newsletters or moving into that platform, please, let's all use each other for some information sharing, so that if you're not using any newsletter and you want to, let's share resources and information on how to get those done. If you need help with any of those things, like I've said before, and we'll continue to say and never tire of saying, contact us. We'd be happy to help you figure those things out. So everything I've said here, I kind of feel like I'm repeating, but it's a good thing to repeat. It's a good thing. It's a good habit. Good habits create a good life. That once you're in these habits, I know when I tell you that you need to do a Facebook post the day it happens, pretty much moments as it's happening or during it, while it's happening. It's kind of a lot and can be overwhelming, but once you do it, you have your phone in your hand most of the time anyway, make those good habits. And then it doesn't become so overwhelming or cumbersome. Make sure, and just kind of a to encapsulize everything or to repeat or review, complement your platforms, your print and your digital, with your colors of your school or parish, the predominant colors that you use, those logos, those hashtags, those taglines. Keep that timing as up to date as possible. If you have a calendar on your website and you aren't using it, please just turn it off for now, unless you're filled up with dates and you're using it. It's no use to you, and actually looks bad when we have calendars that are not current. Same as if you have, and a lot of us are guilty of this, you scroll to your bottom of your page and you're telling people that, hey, we do have a Facebook account, we do have a Twitter account, we do have an Instagram account. Well, and your visitor goes to those, and guess what? The volunteer who used to do the Twitter account doesn't do it anymore. And those, your visitor just went there, and it's from like 2018. I think, oh, this school, they're overlooking this. If you have a platform of social media that you're not using, take it off your website. Take that link off the website. If it's you're not using it because you don't know the passwords or how to get into it, contact us. We'll try to help figure out a way around that. We eliminate a lot of problems, but you want to look current. You want to be user-friendly. Don't have something on your, especially your main page, that is not current, that is not being used. And as I said, continue to share each other's information, ideas. I'd love for you to share the diocesan Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram posts. I would love to see you all share and use the Faith in West Virginia e-bulletin information that we provide every week, whether it's the stories, the prayer intentions, the readings. Those things are all there to help you all. If you're a church, if you're a parish and you have we usually get the e-bulletin out on Friday morning. If you're a parish and you want that information from me a little earlier, give me a shout on an email or phone call, and I'll try to get that information to you personally as soon as I have it ready, if that's the case. And then be insightful. Think about those insights that Facebook gives you. But even if you don't have a Facebook page, listen to what everyone else is saying. They're your insights. They're your Jungle Book insights. Even if you don't have social media and you just have a web page, ask people what they think about your website. And it's okay to get constructive criticism. It all helps us to become better in the long run. And that's why we're here. So this is me. So happy to help you today. And I'm happy to help you all the time. And so is everyone here at the Chancery. I do love working here because it's such a wonderful team. This is my information here, my emails, plain and simple, like all of us here at the diocese. It's our first initial and our last name at dwc.org. My extension here is the extension 357. So let's get back to our Zoom attendance. Let's see here if I can get back to not sharing my screen. Hold on a second. How do I make this big? Do you still see my screen, you guys? Yes. Okay, hang on. Let me see. I'm not savvy like Jen Horniak. Okay, I think that's it. All right, good. So I can see the ones that have shared your video. Do you see me now instead of just my screen? Okay, good. Excellent. All right, let me see. Things I already told you about, National School Public Relations Association. So if you want to write this down, because they do share those award-winning entries, you would just go to nspra.org. Again, that's National School Public Relations Association. So it's nspra.org. They have a digital and publication awards section. It'll be divided into print, digital branding, and they include the links of flyers and social media, and it's so awesome. And again, be a copycat. Copy good practices. Let's see, tomorrow I said I'm doing the PACE for Faith in West Virginia. That's to get ideas to do feature stories. Just did one for Our Lady of Peace alum Adam Marquardt, who started the Confraternity of St. Nicholas. So I'd love to feature young and old, wonderful Catholics around the state, which we've done, I think, 29 stories so far. Love to do some more. So contact me, tune into that PACE session tomorrow, because I'll be talking about that, as well as how to come up with good press releases and photos. So does anybody have questions? I'll be happy to entertain questions. Or if you want to just get on with your day, what time is it? I don't even know, have a clue. 2:14.
I'll make it quick. Can I ask one quick question?
Yes. Yes. Okay,
so it's busy here. So in a given day, I run and I take pictures all over the school, especially on Friday where we have something going on. So then I want to try to get all of my posts done on Facebook before I leave for the day. Yeah. I know that if you don't get it posted in that day, it didn't happen. It doesn't matter.
No.
So do you think that, and I feel like I'm saturating the Facebook page all at once, because like I'm leaving at 3 o'clock and then I am posting every picture we did, like, you know, say it's Halloween Olympics or and also something else happened and student of the month or whatever. Should I be timing those posts like to come out maybe at 5 o'clock, like say I do one before I leave and then I set my timer and then that one goes out a little later in the evening and the next one goes out later in the evening. They still happen in that day, but they're not all being released at 3 p.m. before I leave. Does that matter?
Yeah. If you can't, I would say my opinion is if you can't post within an hour or two of it happening, like if it's something you can't post like during, and like, obviously you're not going to post during mass, but if you can't post it within an hour of getting out of mass because you either teach gym or you teach art or you're doing another wonderful job in the school, like nurse or, you know, a substitute cook. So, which we all have to do at one time or another. I would schedule them, space them out. And there is a scheduling under the business suite of Facebook. You just go to publishing tools and you can do them all at once and just schedule them just so that they're spaced, even if they're spaced 15, 20 minutes apart, that will separate them on someone's, you know, their timeline, their, you know, their news feed, so that they're not just boom, 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 boom. And so, I mean, and then that insights will tell you, hey, what time they're on. And I bet it's peak for a school parent to be on during the school day, but also into the evening. And I bet even your visitors would be well into the evening, like 9 o'clock. So,
yeah. Okay. That's what I thought.
Yeah.
Last time I was doing, I was like, I feel like I'm totally saturating Facebook all at once. Cause once I get home, you know, the kids are all over me.
I know. Exactly. Yes. Cause we all have that stuff we do at the end of our day called life.
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
Yes.
Thanks for that.
You're very welcome. Anyone else? Hey. All right. Well, thanks so much, everyone, for joining me. I appreciate it. Yes. So you're good?
I'm just saying thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome. You're welcome. I was just looking at some names here. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate to email me or call me. I'd love to hear from you and I would love to help you. That's what we're here for. The whole team up here at the Chancery office is ready and willing to make all of us look wonderful. So you all have a wonderful day. If you can tune in tomorrow, it'll be the same time, a different link, but a same time. But email me any thoughts or questions.
Can I ask something?
Yes, absolutely.
Can we put baptisms and that type of stuff on our Facebook? If we have someone baptized or getting married or
I
confirmations
love
or that type of stuff.
I love seeing those. I know that St. Francis in Morgantown does an excellent job at that. And some of our priests, instead of doing it on their church Facebook pages. They do it on their personal pages. But yes, I love that. As long as it's okay with the married couple or the parent, they just might want you to not put their last name, but that would be up to them. But yes, we love to see baptism and marriage and anything to celebrate in a church.
Because I know sometimes we put them on the our webpage, but we don't put their names.
Yeah. Yep. People would love it. And guess what they're going to do? Then when you get that photo up there, that baby being baptized, there's going to be so many people sharing that. That's the baby's family. And that's exactly what you want. You want your wonderful messages there at Immaculate Conception, I'm thinking you're at.
I work at Immaculate Conception. I go to another church that their Facebook page too.
Yes, as often as you can put pictures up of wonderful things happening, do so. I mean, it might even be someone volunteering to clean the church. Snap a picture of them. They'll probably be laughing while you're taking their picture, but even post little things like that just to remind people what a wonderful parish family that they have.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Well, I hope I made sense, and I hope you've walked away with at least one little tidbit of information that will help you. So I'll end today. Thank you so much for joining me, and keep St. Joseph in your corner. It's still the year of St. Joseph, and if you have any problems, you know, my latest thing to say is, come on, St. Joseph, you got to fix this. So hopefully he'll fix everything for you. So have a wonderful day, everyone. Thanks so much for joining, and I hope to talk to you soon. Bye-bye.